And welcome back. Well, back to school means lots of supplies, right? And that list gets expensive for college students. But if your child's preparing to be a college freshman, you need to prepare him or her for how to handle money as well while they're away.
Yeah, Kara Kaiser is managing director of BMO Private Bank right here in Milwaukee. She has some great advice for having those conversations with your freshman college student, or really any age, I think.
Absolutely.
Great to see you.
It's great to see you guys as well.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me.
And it's such an important topic. Paying for college is so expensive, of course, and then you hope that they're going to contribute something, whether it's working or money that they've saved. I remember, too, as a college student, that you get bombarded with credit card offers. And some people recommend college kids should have a credit card. What are your thoughts on
that? That's right. So you turn 18, suddenly you're eligible to do this. So it's kind of on everybody's minds, right? When we were probably in college, right? The rule of thumb, don't just apply for a credit card because you get the free t-shirt. Remember that?
Right,
so
yes.
The good news is that a lot of consumer protection laws have since been enacted where it kind of prevents that activities. But just because you turn 18 doesn't mean that you'll be approved for a credit card.
Mm-hmm.
So you really need to be able to stand on your own with your own income, which a lot of college students may not have consistently. So what we see a lot of our clients do is have a parent apply jointly with their college student for a card, and that allows for a lot of great different benefits, right? The college student does get a card. They can use it for emergencies, and it also allows them to start to learn how to responsibly manage their money. The parent can oversee their spending as well. So they can check in on that and make sure things are being paid on time, they're being paid on full.
Smart.
And perhaps most importantly, it starts to establish a credit history, a
yeah.
track record for that young adult.
Well, because good credit and building it during those years is when it's important, right? Yeah,
absolutely. And I think it's when especially young adults don't realize the impact that can have later. Mm-hmm. What you do at age 18, it's going to hang around with you for the next 8 to 10 years. Anything you pay back, right, your cell phone bill, your utilities to We Energies, your credit card payment, they're going to keep that track record. And when you're 25 and you want to take out a car loan or maybe buy a house, the lenders are going to look at how have you repaid in the past, and that's going to be a factor whether they're going to extend a loan to you in the future.
I will never forget my college roommate had like a Gap card, you know, because in college you wanted the clothes
that's right.
and things
yeah.
like that. Her parents didn't oversee it, and she would always say, free money, you know?
Right.
And that's the mentality
that's
a lot
right.
of kids have
that's right.
in college with a credit card. So I think there's
absolutely.
A lot of pros and cons
absolutely.
To having some of these cards. So what are some of the pros of using a credit
Certainly.
Card? You mentioned some of
that's
them.
That's right. Mentioned some of them about being able to build that credit history,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
A credit card does provide you with protection against lost or stolen fraudulent activities. People often talk about rewards programs, right?
Yeah.
And those can be great. I mean, every dollar you spend, you get a point. You can redeem it for merchandise, travel, cash. I don't know about you. I use my credit card. It's really convenient for online purchases. I need something. I buy it on my phone. It's at my house the next day. That's convenient. You've
mm-hmm.
got to be
yep.
careful with that. But for parents, and if you've got children going off to school, it can be nice peace of mind if an emergency comes up. So
yeah.
maybe their car breaks down, they have to have it towed, they have a way to pay for it. So it can be nice peace of mind that
protection.
Way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What about some of the cons?
Cons, you
free
hit
money.
On it, right? Free money. So don't spend it if you don't have it. And that's a lesson I don't think we do enough education about with our students as they're growing up. If you can't pay for that in 30 days, don't buy it today.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the biggest thing we've got to get across, because you can rack up that debt really quickly. That's a big potential negative. So it's got to be managed well and educate our young adults along the way.
So would a debit card be better? Because that's a lump sum that you just have, and when that's gone, right?
So the debit card is what you've got in your checking account
yeah.
today, right? So it's going to be easier to acquire because the bank will often give you a debit card if you've got an account.
Mm-hmm.
But you've got to make sure that you keep track, that a student's got to keep track of the ins and the outs in their account. It's when you swipe it, it's going to check your account. Is that money there right now?
Mm-hmm.
So there's pros and cons with that. So it won't let you overspend, but you wouldn't want to be embarrassed, or you wouldn't want to be stuck not
yeah.
able to pay for it.
Right. A lot of, like that car example.
Exactly. A
Absolutely.
Lot of people think that I'm sticking
yeah.
to cash. Are there some credit cards that are better, different than others that you think are good for college students?
You know, I think having one card is always a good option.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get them too many. I think
yeah.
that's just enough to manage. Finding the one with the right perks and benefits is important, so people can research that.
Mm-hmm.
What about, just to touch on parents who have younger kids too, and they're trying to save for college, there's good ways to do that to
Absolutely.
Kind of prepare prepare for this moment in advance.
Absolutely. I think the number one thing to remember is it's never too late to start saving for college.
And never too small, right?
Never too small. Absolutely. So the thing that I'm always talking about, right, is it's so important to work with a trusted financial advisor in your life for your family. Someone who understands you, what you're looking to accomplish, and your financial goals, right? So if you've got a financial goal to save for college, maybe for your children or your grandchildren, putting together a plan that helps you get there, understands how much money you want to save over what time horizon, in tandem with all of your other financial goals, making sure you can accomplish all of that is important. It's what we spend all of our time with at BMO Private Bank, surrounding our clients with all the different experts and professionals. No matter what question, what advice, what complex issue, we're there to help solve that.
I love that, because I think finances can be overwhelming and embarrassing sometimes, but they can also be very powerful if you learn how to manage them correctly.
Absolutely.
So here's some great, here's the websites where you can learn more. You can also email. It's reply.wealthmanagement@bmo.com if you'd like to email. Otherwise, bmowealthmanagement.com is the website to learn more about BMO's wealth management programs. Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Good to see you.
Nice job. Great. Important stuff.
Yeah.